Hi, my name is Justin Odisho, and in this Adobe Premiere Pro tutorial, I'm going to be going over everything in the Effects Control panel, one of the most important and foundational panels in Adobe Premiere Pro. So whenever you click and highlight a clip, you should see all of these parameters and information pop up in this Effects Control panel. Make sure you're on that tab and not one of these other ones. And if you don't see it, you can always go to Window and make sure Effects Controls is turned on. But you'll get a different one for if you highlight the audio and the video. And whenever you drag effects onto your clip from the effects panel, where all the video effects lie, for example, let's just say we added a blur effect on here, then you will also see any video effects that you apply pop up on here as well. But I'm going to delete that for now, and we're going to start from, these are the clip effects that are on every clip, starting with the motion effects. So whenever you're working in the effects control panel, you always have the option to drop down or hide things or expand them. So we want to make sure they're expanded. And on the right-hand side, you see our clip and our timeline. This is where we can add keyframes if we wanted. So just to get started, position is pretty standard. You have your position X and Y coordinate, so you can move the X and Y coordinate. Also, whenever you're working with your selection tool active and you have your program window highlighted, if you highlight any of these adjustments, you can also move things around visually just with your mouse. So this can kind of be more useful sometimes than sliding over X and Y parameters. But here you have your position. You also have your scale starting at 100 and going up or down to scale things up or down. And you can also do that with the corners here. Now, another useful tip is that if you ever want to reset anything back to the default parameter, you always have this button in the right, which is reset parameter. And you can click on those, it'll reset everything back to default. And this little stopwatch icon is to toggle animations. So if you ever click that on a parameter, it will create this keyframe, this little diamond. And then if we move over another point on the timeline and change something about this parameter, it will create a keyframe there and then move from one keyframe to the next. I have a whole separate tutorial on keyframes if you want much more in depth on that. But that's the basics. We can just turn it off though by unchecking that stopwatch icon. Another thing with scale is that not only can you just adjust it from 0 to 100, you can also uncheck this uniform scale icon. And here's how you can scale things out or stretch them non-uniformly. So if you wanted for some reason to stretch things out wider than they are vertical, this is a useful tool to be able to do. Also, whenever you drop down these even more, you have these icon sliders if that makes it easier for you to work with. But I'm going to reset that and reset all those. Moving down further, we have rotation, and rotation just works on an angular wheel. So we can go all the way 0 to 360 degrees. And you'll notice once I do pass 360 degrees one time, it'll say 1x plus 2 degrees or 1x plus however many. And the reason it's doing that instead of just looping is for keyframe purposes. If I was to keyframe from 0 to 3 rotations, for example, we'd want to know how many rotations happened. It's not just going from 0 to 360 over. So that's why it says 1x, 2x. And you'll notice whenever we have the keyframes open, these little graphs pop up. And this is just the velocity from which the keyframes are moving into each other, whether it's linear or ramping up in speed or slowing down in speed. And I did cover this again in my keyframe specific tip tutorial, so I'll link you to the keyframe tutorial, but that's besides the point of this one. The next thing we have is anchor point. Now you'll notice when I click on the actual effect, the anchor point typically is always in the center. And this is for rotation purposes or many other purposes. You'll notice it's rotating around the anchor point. However, if I move the anchor point somewhere to the right of the clip, now you'll notice we're rotating around this new anchor point. And many other effects also work based on the anchor point. So this can be useful when you don't want it in the center. This same parameter will pop up in a few different effects. You can reset them back to normal. You can always do that. And another way to reset things back to normal, if you've adjusted multiple things, is just by right-clicking a clip, going to remove attributes, and here it'll let you check or uncheck everything that you want to remove. You'll notice right now the clip has that FX badge turned on yellow. That means we have adjusted some of these video properties. and it'll turn purple or green depending on other effects that you add. But if I turn them all off, you'll notice it turns back to gray, so we know we don't have anything on there. I'd also recommend you check out my video on master effects to learn more about how that works and some more info about the effects badges. But moving on, we have the anti-flicker filter. This one, you can't really tell what's going on, but for certain clips, if you have really sharp edges or some lines that are flickering on some displays or might flicker, whether it's interlaced footage or not, you can turn up the anti-flicker filter a lot and it'll just try to soften that up. And that's the whole motion section. And then after that, we have the opacity section. So by default, you can just lower the clip opacity from 0 to 100%. And another tip also is if you increase your track size, you'll also see this line on the clip. You can also adjust things in this way. But if I was to right click this clip, go to show clip keyframes and change it to something in the motion section, such as the scale, I can also adjust the scale in this way by pulling on that line, even though that's probably not the most intuitive because 0 to 10,000 is not the best range to work with. Now you'll notice for some effects like opacity, we also have this circle, pen, or square icon, and these allow us to mask things out. So if I ever just wanted to mask out a certain part of this clip, like this car, for example, I can create a mask around it and everything else on the clip will become transparent. So this way we can turn down the opacity of some sections of the clip or not. And whenever you have masks turned on, each mask, so this is mask one, will come up with its own properties, such as the feathering amount, the opacity of the mask itself, the expansion of the mask, and different things about it. So you can animate all of these if, for example, you wanted to track an object throughout the screen. That can get a little tedious, but I've done tutorials showing stuff like that. And you can add more than one mask at a time. You'll see both of those different masks will pop up separately, but I can also just click and delete when I want to delete and remove those. Another thing we have is the blending mode. So if I ever actually have two clips on top of each other, let's say this one on top of this one, if I set the blending mode or the opacity down, so I can turn the opacity down, or I can set the blending mode to something like screen, and it will blend these two images based on different multiplicative or additive or darkening blending modes. I have a full separate tutorial as well going over all of the blending modes and layer modes explained that I showed in Photoshop. It's a whole nother subject, but here's where you can blend layers on top of each other and you can do it throughout multiple tracks. So I'll just delete that clip for now, but you can change the blending mode of any layer. And then lastly, we have speed. Now by default, speed usually has the keyframe animation turned on. That's because I can create keyframes. So for example, if I make sure I have this drop down, I can drag up on this velocity line to increase the speed. So you see the clip is getting shorter and shorter as I make the speed get increased. And I can also add keyframes. So I can add a keyframe and then make one half of the clip get slower while the beginning part of the clip is fast. So we can go from fast to slow motion all of a sudden. Now this does have to keep in mind the frame rate of your clip, depending on how it'll look when you speed or slow it down. But there's also multiple different ways, such as the rate stretch tool or just right clicking and going to speed duration to adjust the speed of a clip. So this is time remapping. This is where you can create different ramps of speed and multiple different speeds throughout different parts of the clip rather than just a uniform stretch or shorten. So those are the default ones that come applied onto the clip. And then whenever you do apply things onto the clip as well from the effects folder, you'll see their name pop up and all of those parameters pop up. But you have the same concept and idea for any effect that you apply. And you can stack multiple effects on top of each other and you'll see them all pop up. And also you can arrange these other effects and they'll be applied in the order of arrangement. So keep that in mind. Also, this little effects tab is whether you want to toggle the visibility of an effect on or off. So I can toggle effects on or off without necessarily deleting them. If you ever highlight an audio clip, you'll also get some audio effect controls as well. Just basic ones such as the volume level and the different left and right channel volume. You do also have the audio clip section if you want to just increase the volume of entire channels. but that's going into a separate tutorial territory. So that's a basic introduction to the effects control panel. If you enjoyed this video, definitely check out some of my more in-depth tutorials on keyframe animations, speed, master effects, and more in the playlists on my channel. You can subscribe to my channel here on YouTube to stay tuned for all my new videos, and I'll see you over in the next one. Thank you.